Hello all. Today we will talk about the optimizer engine in ADS. In the last two videos, we talked about getting started with ADS and the power electronics model builder functionality in it. So here's a question. What is the optimizer and how does it make our lives easier? The optimizer tool in ADS helps us tune and build our circuits much quicker in a much more efficient way with minimal manual iteration. Let us take the example of the boost converter we used in the previous video. A simple application to use the optimizer in this example would be to limit the maximum inductor current for a given load at a steady state. High values of ripple current increases the conduction losses and can also cause inductor saturation in boost converters. Using the optimizer in ADS, we can mitigate these effects right at the design stage. So let's understand how this tool works. To explain in general terms, we decide a set of goals for the converter performance, feed it to the optimizer engine, and then the optimizer gives us a set of values for the passive components. The optimizer is basically a highly sophisticated iterative numerical solver that iterates through a permutation of values of the passive components to meet the goals that are fed to it. To understand more in detail how this tool works, I highly recommend going through its help section in ADS. Now let's see how the optimizer makes our design process faster. The first step is to give our optimizer engine a purpose. Now what does that mean? It needs a goal. Let's see how to add a goal to the simulation. This is the example circuit that I'm trying to optimize for this tutorial video. To add a goal, I simply go to the parts list and select the Optim palette and click on the goal option here. Now that this is done, we need to add the optimization engine to the simulation. This is done in a very similar way. Just go to the same palette in the parts list and click on Optim, and here we have our optimizer engine. The optimizer in ADS lets you have multiple goals in the same simulation. However, for this tutorial, we will only have one goal for our engine. Let's see what we have in the optimization goal window. The goal window has two sub-windows. First is the goal information, and second is the display. The goal information window is where you actually set your goals by putting in the expression that you want to optimize, the type of analysis, for example transient, harmonic or Monte Carlo, and the weight of that particular goal. Something worth mentioning is that this input only makes a difference when you have multiple goals. Next, the sweep variable. The last place where the user needs to give an input are the limit lines. The display window is where you choose what you want to see in the goal information window. Now let's talk about setting the goal in the goal information window. The first thing we need to decide while setting up a goal is the expression, meaning the quantity that we want to optimize. Sometimes it might not be obvious what the input for this should be, but it is really very simple. To give you an example, here I want to optimize the inductor current. The input to the expression tab is the exact same expression that I see here for the inductor current in the data display window. Similarly, if we want to optimize, for example, the output voltage, the input to the expression tab would be this, the same thing that we see in the data display window. Next up, we need to write the type of analysis, which is basically the same as the type of simulation we are running. In this case, it is a transient simulation. The weight of a goal, as discussed earlier, makes a difference only when we have multiple goals, so we would not change this variable in this example. Next is the sweep variable. For this, ADS gives two choices by default, frequency and time. We can also add another independent sweep variable like the supply voltage or the value of a resistance by going into the edit option. For this example, I'm going to sweep time to optimize the steady state inductor current. Next thing we do is to set up the limit lines. Limit lines are where we set up maximum and minimum value limits for an expression for a given time window. The optimizer then optimizes the passive components in the schematic so that the limit line constraints are met with the minimum possible error. We can also put multiple limit lines to optimize performance by taking into consideration multiple time intervals. A simple example of this would be if we want the transient overshoot to be less than a specific value and the steady state ripple to be within a certain window. In this example, I'm putting only one limit line that constrains the steady state inductor current. So in the limit lines, I do not want my ripple current to be higher than 2.582 amps. So let's put a time window starting from 5 milliseconds. And the minimum and maximum values for the current would be 2.578 and 2.582. Now we need to set up the optimizer engine. There's not much to talk about when it comes to the optimizer engine. The only thing we change here is the number of iterations. We increase it from a default value of 25 to something like 1000. Even though this looks like a big number, the iterator stops on its own as soon as it reaches the desired error value. So we only iterate as long as there is still an error in our expression value. The last step is to configure the parameters we want the optimizer to change to get the required results. To do this, we go to the Simulate tab at the top to the simulation variable setup. In this, we further go into the optimization configuration window and check all the variables we can afford to change. And that's it. Next, we just run the optimizer and get the results. To run the optimizer, we click here on the schematic window and wait for the optimizer iterations to complete. Once it is complete, we get new values for the variables we had configured to be optimizable, and next step is to just review these values and accept the changes. We thus see how the optimizer tool automates the trial and error involved in designing and simulating power converters. And that's it for this video. For reference, I have attached the workspaces and all the relevant files in the link provided in the description. Thanks for watching.